Okay. Buenos Dias, welcome to pedroTV. I'm here at the Sheffer Gallery with my friend Gilbert Grace. How are you?
Good.
You're nicely warmed up. You've been doing some cycling before
some
coming
cycling,
here?
Yes. We've started off at Burke Street, Burke Street, and we're gradually making our way around to the Maritime Museum for a culture cycling crochet workshop.
Okay, crochet cycling. Now you're here, funny enough, you're here and you've got a solo show here.
I certainly do.
Can you just pan around to show the group of people that came along on the art cycle today? Gilbert, you've just explained your work to them as a group.
Right.
I'm going to ask them to do it again, okay. On camera.
Very, very briefly, most of these, if not all of them, these are all taken from source photographs that I took whilst riding my bike around green spaces in the inner city, in a region of Sydney. So this is also developed into what I call the Sydney Greening, and I've been trying to promote to people as a good active transport corridor, because it actually forms a quite definite ring around and through the centre of Sydney. It hooks up some of the waterways, so you've got Sydney Harbour, Hawthorne Canal, onto Wanko Creek, down to the Cooks River, around to the Mill Stream, back up into Centennial Park, where it follows the Busby Bore from Centennial Park into Hyde Park, and near the actual source of the Tank Stream. So it picks up on all of those very important water sources for Calama City.
Okay, now we're standing in front of some paintings of waterways.
Yes.
I'd like to start perhaps explaining, I'm going to throw you straight into these ones.
Right.
And can you talk more about your actual personal painting approach?
Okay. This whole series is based on me actually cycling and getting source photographs. And then it developed into a research project. The research was into things like the savanna hypothesis and why going in amongst trees and in amongst nature is so recuperative for people, and it's especially good for people from lower socioeconomic backgrounds, where it's been proven to be a boon to their health and well-being, because it helps to relieve stress when you're in amongst green space, close to waterways. So there's a definite actual pattern.
So did you feel like that? I mean,
for sure. That was one of the main reasons that I actually wanted to cycle along these routes, because they were away from cars, they were away from the stress and the strain. It would give me a chance to actually clear my lungs, because I used to paint in the studio. So by the end of the afternoon, I'd like to go out and just get some fresh air, sunshine, some vitamin D, all that sort of stuff.
So it's a transition for you between the working day and the night. And you've spoken a bit at length about that. You want to talk about how, you know, you find yourself on a cycle in that kind of period between, the end of the day and the start of the night.
These are all based on the idea of liminality. Liminality means a transition from one state to another. So the transition from daytime to nighttime is a luminous level, or from nighttime to daytime. Also the transition from water to land, or from, say, green space to suburb. These are all luminal states. There's a luminal time of day, which is the transition from night to day. There's a luminal space, which is the transition from water to land or water. And there's also a transitional ritual, which celebrates and ritualizes the various transitions that human beings go through, from childhood to adulthood, and from adulthood to a senior adult or a more responsible adult. So this is part of this, describing this process as well as illustrating. Also from a state of illness, possibly, to a state of wellness. So that's another form of liminal transition. And being in nature and surrounded by nature, exercising, that whole idea of neurogenesis, when you're actually doing physical work and stimulating the environment, it helps to rebuild brain cells, it helps to rebuild your resistance and your ability to withstand the trials and tribulations of everyday life.
Can I now ask you to talk about this book, where this one in particular seems like you're thrown into the urban streetscape, and I imagine there are car headlights and... Can you talk about this particular one?
Okay, as I said, all of these are based on the Sydney Greenery, so I've followed the course and taken photographs whilst I was riding. This one is actually taken from Market Street, which runs from Hyde Park down to Darlington, and it's looking up Castle Row Street, or down Castle Street, up Castle Row Street, towards Secular Quay. So on our right hand side here is David James Wing's store. So the time of day, there's just a whole lot of reflections, camera shape and everything else played part, but I just thought the original source photo was so wonderful that I just wanted to use that, and it described the space really well from a cyclist's perspective as well. Mm-hmm. This whole idea of light and movement and indiscernible sort of shapes.
You really have to be alert.
Yes, so you've got to use peripheral vision is very important, so you can't always make out the detail that you can see.
Yeah, I mean, that's the thing with twilight. All the clear shapes of the day are losing their form.
Yeah.
They're becoming formlessness.
Yeah.
Now, one of the things I really love about your painting is that, the light when there's blurriness, you know, that's a classic example. It's more pronounced in here where, you know, there are little details we're not sure what they are, and you know, that's a house rooftop, but I wouldn't have a clue what that particular thing is.
There's trees, basically.
It's a tree?
Yeah, trees, because the houses are very low. Mm-hmm. That's a street in the mid-ground.
Mm-hmm.
But there's trees, because this is actually on the Hawthorne Canal. So this is the Richard Merton Reserve on that side, and the Hawthorne Reserve on this side. So this is the dog walking area.
Okay.
Dog off leash area. The canal is just this narrow strip running through the centre of it.
Right. It's a stormwater canal.
It's actually built on Long Cove Creek, which stretches right back up into up near Trinity Grammar,
mm-hmm.
up into that area of Dulwich Hill, Sunhill. And it has been turned into a stormwater canal. And the original idea was to actually build the canal through from Sydney Harbour
mm-hmm.
to the Cooks River.
Mm-hmm.
With the idea being that Sydney Harbour would then help to flush all the sediment out of Cooks River. And this is part of a canal building program that they had during the, or just after the First World War, I think mm-hmm. it was, to employ people, which is why it got lined and it's now a heritage item, the Hawthorne Canal. They used to actually run ferries about halfway up the canal.
Okay. So it's pretty big.
That was at one stage, but it's obviously silted up now and it's full of rubbish and troughs.
One thing I haven't heard you talk about is the skies and the clouds.
The skies
and
clouds. I mean,
most of the time they actually dominate, in a lot of your paintings, actually dominating. So, tell me about painting clouds.
This is this wonderful thing about a sign can carry so many meanings and signify sort of messages. The clouds, for me, it speaks to so many things like the ephemeral nature of clouds, but also the fact that in a carbon-rich environment,
mm-hmm.
you end up with so much more beautiful radiant sunsets and sunrises. So what happens is you end up with more pinks and more reds. So what we're going to look forward to is the amount of carbon in the atmosphere rises and the amount of water vapor in the atmosphere rises, because they both go together, is that we're going to have more spectacular sunsets and sunrises.
Mm.
And this is possibly an unwanted side effect of global warming.
I think they're pretty good anyway, but okay, well, thanks very much.
Thank you, Pedro.
Fantastic show of wonderful painting, different kind of locations, obviously lots of concepts and ideas, but just to stand in front of one of these, and it's great that we recognise, or I do, and a lot of other people, we live in these places, and we all walk, you know, from the end of the day to the beginning of the night through them, and we all feel these emotions, and you've captured them, I think. So congratulations.
That's cool.
Fantastic.
Shows until the 10th of November.
And you run your art cycles pretty much all the time.
Art tours, we'll be having tours throughout the summer months and into 2013. So,
thanks. And next week, stay tuned for another interview with a fascinating visual artist. So for now, adios.